one and all. My name is Rio and welcome back to another Match Day vlog. So today, Chester FC play away Nuneaton Borough at Liberty Way in the Vanarama National League North. So it's going to be another huge game for us now running because Nuneaton Borough, they could actually get relegated today. So a bit sad to be honest because they are a nice club actually. But if we don't lose today, then they will go down to the Evo Stick Southern Central Premier League. So, you know, it will be sad for them. But last season we got relegated and we know what it's like, you know, to have a relegation. But we just got to do our own thing today, get the 3 points. And hopefully, you know, have a big say in the playoff battle. So yeah, it should be a good day for me today, you know, down in Warwickshire. So it should be a nice match as well. So hopefully you enjoyed the video today. Please leave a like and subscribe to my channel. And also feel free to comment down your thoughts on the game below. So let's get into today's video right now. Nuneaton Borough have had a dreadful season so far and they have spent most of it in the relegation zone, so they have had a really bad season both on and off the pitch because off the pitch back in November they nearly went bust for the second time in the space of 10 years, so you know, it wasn't great for them. However, their fans did rally around, so fair play to them, and thankfully they were safe. But still, you know, things aren't too secure, you know, because they have had to offload a number of their key players, including Adam McGurk, who scored at the Swans frame back in November, and also Carl Baker, who now plays for Brackley Town. So they have had to offload a couple of their key players, but still Nuneaton, they have struggled. So they have done, you know, they haven't done too well at all. I think they've only won about four matches in total, so no, very bad. However, they did actually win last Saturday. They beat FC United in Manchester away 4-0, so you know, a bit of a cute result for them. It's not like they're going to stay up, but at least they did have something to cheer about. So it's fair to say that they haven't really got anything to play for now, and as I say, they could get relegated today. However, I think all the pressure is going to be on us today because, as I say, Nuneaton, they haven't really got anything to play for now, so you know, they'll be playing out to their skin. However, for us, we've really got to get the 3 points today. It's win or bust, really, in my opinion, because it's currently 5 points separate us, 5 points separate us and AFC Telford United, who are in seventh place. So, Telford, they're away at top of the league, surely, today, so hopefully, surely we'll win today, and also we're away at bottom of the table and on Eton. So if we win today and Telford's losing, we'll only be 2 points away from the playoffs. And also don't forget we have a game in hand on Tuesday against Stockport, so you know, this could be huge for us. So hopefully we'll get a big win today. But as I say, you know, commiserations to on Eton because they have been you know, in the relegation zone for most of it. However, they have been one of the best footballing sides, you know, to come to the Swans this season. We beat them at home 3-2 back in November, and I actually thought they were a good side back then. They played some really good football as well, so you know, you can argue that they don't really deserve to be bottom of the table because they played some really good stuff. And also, we were 3-0 up on the 50th minute mark, and Nuneaton, they scored twice in the you know, in the last 10 minutes to you know, cause a bit of a scare for us. You know, thankfully we got over the line in the end, but still they actually played well that night as well. So who knows what they could play out today, you know, who knows what sort of side they could field. But for us, we got to get the win today, otherwise you know, players can go out the window. So yeah, should be a great game today. I've never been to Nuneaton before, and you know, they played the Liberty Way Stadium, holds over 4,500. It's not too bad, to be honest. It's better than a few grounds in this league, but to be honest, it isn't too great. But I suppose it does do the job, and it is mostly open as well. So you know, on one side you have the main stand, which got a nice I think holds over 500 seats, and you know, got a nice cover stand there, which goes towards one goal. The rest of it is just a flat stand and terrace. But and also behind that are a few porter cabins as well, which contain the clubhouse and the offices and all of that. Opposite that is the south terrace, which again is mostly an open terrace, but still you have the turnstiles there as well. Behind one goal you have the Britannia Tyre stand, which is a decent stand, to be honest. It is a nice covered terrace where you can make a good atmosphere there as well. I think holds under 2,000 people there as well, so it is a really nice terrace as well. Then behind the other goal is a similar terrace, and it's called the Loans to Go stand. And again, it is a bit like the former, but it's just a bit smaller in size as well. So again, that's not a bad stand either. So I don't know whether today's game will be segregated or not, but if it is to be segregated, then we will be allocated relegated part of the main stand, and also we will be in the loans to go stand too. So it should be a great day for us, and hopefully we'll be able to complete the double over the Nuneaton this season, because that's to say back in November in the reverse fixture we beat Nuneaton at home 3-2. So a bit of a close game that night, but still we managed to get the 3 points as well. So it should be a good game today. And also must add that our previous meetings with Nuneaton have resulted in a few goal fests. So back in 2014 we lost 3-2 away. Then a few months after that, we beat them at home 5-3, so a bit of a thriller there on the last day of the season. And also back in November, we beat them at home 3-2. So maybe another goal fest today, but as long as we get the 3 points and hopefully boost our goal difference up a bit, then I'll have no problems with that as well. So on to my score prediction then. So I think it'll be Nuneaton Borough 1, Chester FC 3. So for Nuneaton, I think Taylor Allen will score for them. And for Chester, I think Craig Mahon, Akwasi Asante and Gary Roberts will score for us. So if I'm getting these, win today, which will boost our playoff chances. So it should be a great game today, never been there before, so looking forward to it now. So of course I hope you enjoyed the video today. Please leave a like and subscribe to my channel. Also feel free to comment down your thoughts on the game below. So let's get into today's video right now. My match day vlog will be coming up right now, so come on City, don't let me down, we can do this. Up the Seals. Arrived at Liberty Way now, hoping for a big Chester win today. To be fair though, the ground is very out of the way. It took me about 10 minutes to find a turnstile, a bit of a weird location here, but to be fair it's actually alright. To be fair, got a few nice stands here. Need a win today though, definitely. 3 points or plus, but I'm confident we'll get a win today, so looking forward to it now. Come on City, we can do this. here is Nuneaton Borough squad for today's game. And here is your Chester FC squad for today's game. And we are in a 4-4-2 formation. In goal is number 1, Grant Shenton. In defence is 2, Bradley Jackson. 3, Matty Waters. 5, Danny Livesey. And 6, Simon Grant. Midfield is 4, Sean McAllister. 7, Ben McKenna. 8, Captain Gary Roberts. And 11, Dan Mooney. And up front is 9, Akwasi Asante. And 10, Anthony Dudley. On the substitutes bench is 12, Steve Howson. 14, George Green. 15, Craig Mahon. 16, Lloyd Marsh-Hughes. And 17, George Raring. Enjoy the vlog. Up the Seals.
Come on, Akwasi. Yeah! Get in! Come on, Yellows! Come on. 1-0, Chester.
Yellows!
Only played a couple of minutes, but already Nuneaton 0, Chester 1. Akwasi Asante, it was a good goal. It was, took the ball on the edge of the area and just slotted it home. Perfect start for us. Nuneaton 0, Chester 1, get in. Nuneaton have a corner, but I thought the ball actually went out for our throw-in a minute ago, but it's gone in. And Bradley Jackson cleared it out. So far, about 10 minutes gone, we're absolutely dominating this game so far. Akwasi Asante scored, proving the difference, and yeah, so far so good. We now have a free kick. Ben McKenna did really well to get the ball off the Nuneaton midfielder and the Nuneaton player brought him down, so we have a free kick here. It's going to be taken in a minute by Gary Roberts, but it's a bouncy ball on the pitch. The linesman's just took the bouncy ball away. So it's going to come in now by Roberts. Come on, oh, it's hacked away. Nuneaton just boosted it downfield. Grant Shenton has just made a fantastic save. Nuneaton player, took the ball on the volley, blasted it towards goal. Shenton made a great save, and they now have a corner. Just had a chance there, claimed by Grant Shenton, easy capturing. Come on, Asante! Asante's in here. He's on the left hand side. Shoot! Oh, lucky. Dan Mooney's shot blocked. Oh, lucky. Just hoof it away. Still playing well here. I'd say it's a bit of an even game now, but still 1-0 City. Mooney, hit it. Go on, Asante. Oh, playing a bit scrappy here. I think this game's gone a bit scrappy now. Not playing too well. I think we're in the better side, but no need to now coming into it a little bit. Nuneaton 1, Chester 1, very disappointing. Nuneaton, they had a free kick and the goalkeeper took a free kick. And a bit of a mix up with the defence, but Nuneaton, it just easily scored. Poor defending there, and it's now 1-0, got work to do.
Sharpe. A shot by Akwasi Asante was easily saved by the Nuneaton goalkeeper. Unlucky. Another shot by Asante saved. This time it was a bit better. But things have been a bit scrappy so far. Still 1-1. Nuneaton had just had a great chance there. Play struck the ball on the edge of the area. A decent strike, but just went over. We are starting to come into this game a little bit more now because Anthony Dudley, he has another chance there, which was saved by the keeper. As I say, I think it hasn't been a great game so far. You know, I think both sides have just been hoofing it up and hope really. Need to be taking advantage from Nuneaton because I still think they're a great side, but we haven't really, you know, been any, you know, produced anything special today. It's Nuneaton 1, Chester 1 at half time. I think first half, but we got off to a great start. Asante scoring after, I think it's about 2 minutes. Got off to a great start, but since then, just sat back and it's been a poor game, I think, in my opinion. Very scrappy and the pitch is very bubbly too, so it's not helping, but I think we've been quite poor today. Had a number of chances, but I think both sides haven't really, you know, got the ball down, you know, on the pitch as well. So half-time 1-0, got a lot of work to do because, you know, can't be drawing, you know, against these. Now, got to be winning against them today. You know, no need to bottom in the league. Got to win today, so got work to do, but hopefully a good second half. Afternoon, yeah, but you'd be right, won't it? Grant Chancellor's made another fantastic save. The Nuneaton player had a shot on the edge of the area and he made a fantastic save to tip the ball wide. But I'd say Nuneaton started off as the better side in the second half.
Yellows! Yellows!
Yeah! Come on! Get it! Come on, City! Getting there. I think it was Danny Livesey. The corner went in by Ben McKenna and Danny Livesey put the ball in the net and it's Nuneaton 1, Chester 2. Get in. Asante had all the time in the world, but he just passed it to an Nuneaton player. Second half doing a lot better now, and here's Dan Mooney on the ball. Coming out, shoot Asante.
Yellows.
We have just won the corner, so Dan Mooney took it, and now it's into Roberts. Oh, unlucky there. Header by Steve Howson's just gone over, but yeah, I think we're doing really well now second half. I think we started off a lot better when we got the early goal again. Hopefully we won't concede again, but I think we're doing a lot better now. Nuneaton have just missed an absolute sitter. Their left winger made a great run on the left hand side. He crossed it in and their play in the middle, unmarked, had all the time in the world, just blazed it over. But we've got about 20 minutes left now. So yeah, I think it's going to be, you know, a big 3 points today. And as it stands, Telford are getting beat by Chorley, so we'll only be 2 points off the playoffs as it stands. So for game in hand too. Need to have a free kick for, right on the edge of the area, so it's coming, and I think it's George Waring who made the last ditch clearance. Go on Jackson, have a shot. It's probably Jackson on the ball, by the way.
Oh, he's lost it. Well, why don't you just pass it to Asante? You know, Bradley Jackson, look, he had all the space in the world. He just, you know, a bit of a poor play there, I'd say. Nuneaton had just had the chance there, one of their players took a really long throw which went right into the area. Fair play to him, was a really good throw, but their player just heading it wide, so a bit of a let off there. But second half, haven't been outstanding, but I'd say we deserve to win because Nuneaton, they've been really poor, and as it stands, they're getting relegated. Commiserations to them, but I think they've been really poor today. I don't think we've been fantastic, but still, any win's a win. And that, you know, the stage of the season means that little bit more. Oh! Asante went to clash with their keeper then. Craig Mahon has been brought down, so we now have a free kick from about 25 yards out on the left hand side. So Gary Roberts is going to take it any second now. So it has come in anyway. Towards the back. Oh, unlucky. George Waring just missed the ball. You know, if he had got contact on that would go right into the back of the net. That would. You know, it could have been 3-1 then. Nuneaton just had another chance then. They had a free kick which was whipped in there, one of their players. He controlled it on his chest and his volley, it was a decent volley to be fair, dipping volley as well. Well, Grant Shenton caught it, but you know, could have gone in. You know, it wasn't too far away from going in. But got about 10 minutes left now. You know, this win will be really good for us today because you know, we have a game in hand on Tuesday against Scotport, don't forget that. And also now as it stands we are only 2 points away from the playoffs.
Yellows! Yellows!
Yes, we are only 2 points away, so who knows what can happen now. We have 5 games left after this. I say win at least 4 and then who knows, anything can happen. Come on, Mahon! Oh, come on, George Green. Oh no, what was that? I don't know what that was, because a cross by George Green went into Ben McKenna, just a couple of yards on, headed, you know, I don't know, just heading miles wide, and could have gone in. Wow, that was a bad header, but yeah, 10 minutes left, still 2-1 Chester, please hang on. Nuneaton 2, Chester 2. I'm sorry, but again, that was a really poor goal to concede. Yet again, both goals we conceded today have been awful. The cross went in and Grant Shenton flapped at it and he just tapped it home. Terrible goal. Awful goal to concede. 2-0. That was, oh my, I don't know what to say really, that was an awful goal to concede, that was. Both goals as well today. This is awful. 2-0 anyway.
Hey! Come on! No way! Stonewall penalty that.
George Waring brought down and the referee just ignored it. Blatant penalty. We have hit panic station C and Tonya now, the other corner. Come on now, get out, it's been headed away. Come on now! Come on, Sean! Oh. Put him under. Tonya now, if we draw today, I'll be absolutely livid. Because Nuneaton, they've been really poor today. Tonya now, we just haven't capitalised. Gary Roberts has made a bad challenge and they have a free kick now again. It's gone. No way! Shenton, last minute, you know, he made a good save to be fair. Fair play to Shenton. But Nuneaton, they almost got a third then, and that would have been all.
Come on, make it
Thankfully we have a bit of a chance here because we've just gone up the other end of the field and we've won ourselves a corner. It's going to be taken by George Green, excellent Nuneaton player. yeah, so it's going to be taken any minute now. As soon as this Nuneaton player gets up, because he's been brought down to the other end, having a bit of a spat with Grant Shenton. So, yeah, got about 5 minutes now, and yeah, the corner's going to come in now anyway by George Green. Come on, it's our last hope really now. Oh, we have another corner. Come on, City! We have another corner. Their player headed it over. Yellows! Yellows! Ben McKenna was taking the corner. Oh, yeah! 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 Come on! Yeah! Yeah!
Come on!
God, we've only gone and done it. I can't believe that. I was deflated a minute ago, but now I'm absolutely buzzing. Steve Howson scored for us. Wow. I mean, it's only Nuneaton, but come on, that's injury time goal. Come on, Chester. Oh, I'm buzzing right now. I really am buzzing. It's going to be a big win as well. Oh, come on, City. We can do this. Get in. Yeah! Full time! Get in! Yay! Come on, City! Come on!
Oh, I'm really time winning away from home. Come on.
Ah, I missed.
Oh, I can only play off the limit.
Hey, jammy yellows.
Yellows, yellows. Full time, Nuneaton 2, Chester 3, last minute seats here. Delighted, absolutely delighted. We don't half make it hard for ourselves, do we? But hey, what a win, and sadly, Nuneaton, they're relegated, so commiserations to them. You know, gutted for them, but hey, come on Chester, what a win. Our playoff hopes are well and truly alive. Come on!
Nuneaton Borough 2, Chester FC 3. Oh my god, hey. So what a win today. But, you know, just got back now, 7:30. And that journey home was fantastic. You know, that was a bloody good journey home. But before I start my post-match analysis, I got to, you know, give my commiserations to Nuneaton, who did get relegated today. So, you know, I am gutted for them because, you know, nearly a year ago today, we were suffering the same pain as them because, you know, we lost 2-0 at home against Tranmere Rovers in our own backyard against, you know, one of our biggest rivals. So, we suffered the same fate last year. So, I am gutted for Nuneaton, but hopefully next season they'll rebuild themselves in the Eastern Central Southern Leagues. But anyway, you know, what a win today, you know. I thought the actual match was a 5-goal thriller. I thought the actual match was really poor today. Again, to be honest, I thought it was a really scrappy game. Thought the pitch was, you know, very bobbly. Didn't help. It wasn't the worst pitch I've ever seen, but, you know, it didn't really help today. But I thought the actual match, it wasn't the best. I thought it was quite poor today. And I thought our actual performance, it wasn't the best. But the thing is, it is a sign of a good team when you don't play well, but somehow you do win. So, yeah, anyway, last minute limbs it was today. Danny Livesey, take a bell, a defender, central defender who managed to score two today. What a goal it was as well in injury time. So, you know, just delighted with that today. You can see by my face, and still getting over it. Might take me a day or two to get over it, you know, ahead of Tuesday's massive game at Stockport. But, yeah, so let's go into the game. So, I don't think we played well today. I thought Nuneaton, they were really poor as well. I thought they were dreadful. No disrespect at all. I am gutted that they got relegated, but I actually thought that they were a really poor side today as well, because, you know, in the first half, we could have scored 5 or 6. You know, we could have been, like, 6-1 up at half-time. You know, it's that easy for us, but, we just didn't take advantage, really. But I thought we were quite poor. I thought both sides, you know, just had that habit of hoofing the ball up as well, so we didn't play our usual, you know, attractive, you know, passing style of football. You know, we just tended to hoof the ball up the pitch, really. So, you know, it was a bit disappointing in the first half. However, we did actually get off to the best possible start, though, because Akwasi Asante, he made it 1-0 towards after 4 minutes. It was a good goal, too. Good work by both, I think it was Dan Mooney and Ben McKenna. You know, they played really well today, especially Ben McKenna. More on him in a minute, because he was my man in the match today. But, you know, those two, you know, played really well. You know, in the first goal, they played a really good role. And Akwasi Asante slotted at home to make it 1-0. You know, great start for us. And I say for the next 10 minutes, we still, you know, dominated Nuneaton. We had one or two other chances as well. But, in a fair play to the host, I thought, you know, they started to get into the game a bit more. I thought they were, I thought they were poor today. I thought they were very bad today, but fair play. You know, I thought the first half was a bit, you know, end-to-end, not in a good way as well, because Nuneaton, they had a few chances as well. Grant Shenton, he made a few top draw saves as well. I can recall a Nuneaton player having a volley from about 25 yards, a first-time volley too. Grant Shenton made a fantastic save, an excellent save to tip the ball over the bar, so, you know, fair play to Shenton. But yeah, Nuneaton, he actually started to power the pressure on a little bit, and we were a bit shaky, we were a bit shaky, and eventually, past the half hour mark, Nuneaton, they got the equaliser. And I'm going to be honest, both goals today were really poor, you know, very disappointing and frustrating. Both goals we conceded today, both defensive errors, and we got to work on that, you know, on the training ground ahead of our two crucial home matches this week. But, the Nuneaton keeper, Cameron Belford, used to play for that lot down the road. You know, we actually took the free kick right on the halfway line, and it almost went in. Fair play, you know, Belford, he actually hit the post, so... the Nuneaton goalie hit the post and play, you know, he rebounded it in to make it, get the equaliser. But he was unmarked too, so, defensively, lack of communication there defensively, so we must work on that on the training field ahead of Tuesday and Saturday. But yeah, 1-1, alarm bell started to ring a bit then. We actually had a few chances though before half time, you know, a few half chances. Anthony Dudley and Akwasi Asante both had a few chances, which went wide, but went into the break 1-1. I think it was a scrappy half as well, so a bit disappointing, you know. Thought the first half, said my half time thoughts that we weren't up to standards. I thought we played okay, but just not up there really. Second half, I thought it was the same in the first half really. It was a bit end to end, not in a good way. But I thought, you know, in the second half we were a tiny bit better. I thought we still dominated Nuneaton, but I was watching Burden Morley's post-match interview as well, and even he said that, you know, we weren't outstanding today. But as I say, it's a sign of a good team when you don't play well, but somehow grind out a result, which is it's the most important thing at this time of the season, this critical stage, that we just get the points, you know, because we have got a bit of an advantage now. Because Telford, they drew 1-1 away at Chorley today, so I was looking on my phone before full time, and it's still 1-0 to Chorley on the 88th minute mark. But Telford, they scored the late equaliser, so You know, we're still 3 points behind the playoffs now with a game in hand as well. So hopefully if we get a win on Tuesday, then we'll be right in the mix as well. But anyway, talk about that later. Second half though, but you know, second half started off really well again. Just like the first half as well, we took the lead, you know, just within minutes. So, you know, our second goal was scored by Danny Livesey. Good goal as well, you know, good work by Ben McKenna. You know, the cross went in by Ben McKenna. You know, great cross as well, you know, to get an assist for Danny Livesey, who just slotted it home. So, good goal to make it 2-1, you know, considering we were a bit frustrated, you know, before. Hand, but you know, made it 2-1, and we have further chances as well. I think it was Matty Waters, I think he had the chance as well. I think Asante had the chance as well. But you know, the Leeds, they got back into it as well. You know, they had a few spells down the left hand side. You know, I can recall that Danny Livesey slipping and one of their players, you know, we just blasted it over the crossbar. So you know, we had one or two scares, we were a bit fortunate at times. But sadly, Nuneaton, they got the second equaliser of the game. It was, again, you know, really poor goals conceded. And I thought Grant Shenton, he had a really good game today. But the second goal he conceded today was, you know, really, really not good at all. So Nuneaton, there was a bit of a goalmouth scramble. And, you know, the initial shot was saved by Shenton. But instead of actually catching the ball, he just flapped it, really. He just carried it out, you know, in a bit of a bizarre, you know, rushed fashion. You know, the Nuneaton player, we just bundled it over the line. So, you know, really, really bad goals conceded. And, you know, again, must work on that in the training field. But, you know, we were starting to realise that we were going to draw today. You know, at the, you know, the, at that part of the game, you know, 2 points dropped was just not going to be enough for us. However, once again, Danny Livesey, he had other ideas, and it was a bit of a Ben Hennigan-esque moment, really. 94th minute winner, centre half, what more could go wrong? So, again, Ben McKenna, it was both Ben McKenna and Livesey who teamed up again, because, you know, as I said, I'll talk to you more about Ben McKenna in a minute, because he got two assists today. He was exceptional. But, you know, a cross went in by Ben McKenna. No, it wasn't a cross, it was actually a corner, if I can remember rightly. So a corner went in by McKenna, and Danny Livesey, he headed it home to in front of the away to send us all into the raptures. It was absolutely delirium, limbs, scenes, whatever you can call it. It was absolutely, you know, phenomenal to get the win. I know it's Nuneaton, but still, a last minute win away from home against anyone in the league, you know, it just feels the same, really. It just felt that extra good. So Livesey, man in the moment, he got the win, a winning goal for us. And you know, fair play. Don't think we played too well today, but you know, we got to win, which is all that matters. So fantastic win today. What more can I ask from us? Now we have a massive game on Tuesday against Stockport County. So for Ben McKenna, you know, he was my man in the match today. You know, he was really good on the ball. You know, going forward, you know, he made some really good crosses, and also he got two assists as well. So he was fantastic today. You know, Grant Shenton, he made a big mistake for the second goal, but still he made some you know, top draw saves. And also both Sean McAllister and Gary Roberts, they did all the hard, dirty work in the middle of the park as well. You know, and Roberts, he made some good set pieces as well. So you know, thought, you know, I don't really think anyone put in a bad shift today, but I just thought that we weren't up to standards. But anyway, we got the win today. What more can I ask for? You know, we got the win, and that's all that matters, really. So looking forward to Tuesday night now. Our next match is against Stockport County at home on Tuesday at the Swan Suite. It's an all-ticket game as well, so you know, if you haven't got your ticket already, make sure to get it, because you know, we've got a win today. Get down to the Swan Suite. You know, your last chance to get a ticket is on Monday, so make sure to get down to the Swan Suite. Get your ticket then. Hopefully see us get a big win on Tuesday. So we'll be going to the game. As ever, we'll be doing a match day preview and the vlog out soon, so look out for those two videos as well. Sorry, you know, starting to lose my voice a bit there, because it was, you know, last minute drama today. So yeah, of course, I'm sure you enjoyed today's video. Like, subscribe as usual. Feel free to comment down your thoughts on the game below. Up the Seals, what a win. Let's keep this run going. Come on, lads.